Welcome to Electra Online. We're now going to embark on showing you a number of properties for the Fourier transform. The reason why we do that, not because we want to get too theoretical, they actually are very useful in trying to find the Fourier transform of some functions, some input functions. Now this may, the first one right here, the property called linearity, may be something really simple and straightforward, but actually comes in quite handy sometimes. So let's say that we have two input functions. Let's call them f1 of t and f2 of t, and these are then the Fourier transforms in the frequency domain. Well, if that's the case, then we can say, and this is what we call the linearity property, that the Fourier transform of a constant multiplied by the first input function plus a different constant multiplied by the second input function, so we take the Fourier transform of the sum of those two, then that will be equal to that very same constant times the Fourier transform of the first input function plus that second constant times the Fourier transform of the second input function. You may look at that and go, well, of course, that makes sense. Why shouldn't it be that way? Well, it's always good to show mathematically that's indeed the case. So what we're going to do here is take the Fourier transform of that particular input, the sum of those input functions, each of them multiplied by a constant. So that will look like this, times e to the minus I omega t, integrated from minus infinity to infinity. Because of the plus sign, we can separate them, and because of a1 and a2 being constants, we can pull them outside the integral sign. Now when you take a look inside the integral sign, notice this is just strictly straightforward, the form that we would expect to see of a Fourier transform of some input function as in the time domain, and then each of those can then easily be said, well then this will be the Fourier transform of this, because that's what we claimed over here, and this will be the Fourier transform of the second input function, and since we pull the constants out, we simply multiply the constants times each of those two results, and you can see that, sure enough, that linearity property does hold water, and it's actually a quite useful one, as simple as it may be. We'll show an example on the next video.